here in 1982, and then was a letter written at Ambos in 1960, when one... Positioning run, this first look, prior to over the Mildenhall woods. The B-52H, last example thereof, was delivered in October of 1963. First flight of the prototype aircraft was in April 1952. Sorry, now, repositioned for a closer look. Tim Hansen, his crew, and the B-52H. B-52Hs still serving now in the conventional role. Recalled at Airfake 91 with examples that have taken part, the B-52 in contrast this time, all that undercarriage down and the B-52 at the slow.
remember, this is an airplane design as a 44-seat airliner under 7 days. The top of the AAA 70 hours F-27. It looks a conventional takeoff.
C-141Bs entered service in January 1980.
Those rear doors can be opened in flight by 152 side facing seats. In the 171 mph generally cruising at around 495. The power comes from four Bradford DTM-33.
Of course, the canopies that they use, very high position canopies, up the relative group, six joined hand to hand, working their way down as they track at around 120 miles an hour. Legs and arm tucked very closely together by those on the outside who accelerate to around 180 miles an hour, and watch as they work outwards to bracket those falling at the centre. The relative group, who by presenting more resistance to the air, slow in their passage, and watch as all of them reach about 2,000 feet, and there the relative group split. And as they came there, the 3,000 foot mark, the canopy's open. Now the next part of the routine is to establish the stack as quickly as possible. And the team coach, in this instance, it's Flight Sergeant Steve Tucker. He's the key man in this process. He, in fact, is the first man down, the man at the bottom of the stack. And everyone else has to fly relative to him. Trailing edge of the canopy, allowing it to be used just like an aircraft control. It's used differentially as ailerons or together as flaps. By this means, the canopy can be flown at a forward speed from 25 miles an hour all the way down to zero and indeed the stall, and you'll see that very much demonstrated as the stack arrives down to ground level. Steve Tucker Stack in there, nicely formed spiral. Smoke canisters on their boots, marking their passage. Generally speaking, it's the most experienced members of the team, and you can see some very good uniform spacing at the bottom of the stack. The newer members of the team in the upper margins. Just like the arrows, generally speaking, team members serve 3 years at a time with the Falcons. And just like the arrows too, to avoid the wind. And looks like arriving very precisely. There, right in the middle of one of the crosses. Flight Sergeant Steve Tuckerden, the team coach. Sergeant Ishwood, Flight Lieutenant Steve Darling, the team leader, is the next man down. Sergeants Probert and Piers, Ashwood, Wright, Dawson, Robinson. Flight Captain Steve Cabley. Series indeed from the United States Air Force. In the process, reminding of another role in which Harriet Mildenhall so significantly served the United States Air Force. When, as we've already seen, something of the performance that allowed this aircraft to enjoy a very particular role for a very long period of British military history.
It is the
main part of the formation, followed by the T-7. Then the R-5.
Right, you know what you're going for there.
Oh, it's got a bit, it's got a picture of the camera. It's a button out the
plane there. It's a
What do you mean? You didn't hear that?
Yes, I did.
I
like to congratulate Steve and his team for that truly immaculate demonstration of precision parachuting. They'll be forward to pack their canopies in a little while. So those of you down there to the side of the control tower will get a chance to talk with members of the team while we make ready for the Hercules to land on. Indeed, the team will then board and they'll be off again for more displays tomorrow.
Five aircraft, the leading five aircraft, the best route.
low altitude visible for the 8-9 race.
Thank you. flying the Jaguar.
Okay,
yeah.